God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
God, to all hearts are open, all desires known. For you know the secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity and the power of your divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith and worship, and bring us at last to see you in your one and eternal glory. Father, who with the Son and the Holy Spirit live and reign one God forever and ever.
The first lesson comes from the book of Isaiah. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on the throne, high and lofty, and the hymn. of the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you are living according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children of God, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If in fact we suffer with him, so then will we also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as we ready.
Jesus answered him, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh. What is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly, I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Seated. The Holy Spirit works in all sorts of interesting ways. Sometimes, actually, for worship. For example, Barbara has chosen a hymn here that perfectly fits what I'm about to say. So there it is. God is good. Let there be light. Where the gospel does not shed its glorious ray, let there be light. The Gospel of John, as you probably know, or have noticed, is all about light and darkness. That's the theme, or sort of the leitmotif that runs all the way through the Gospel. From the very beginning, if you remember, the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the light shined in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. It's that durability of the light of God that overcomes the darkness of the world. And Nicodemus is part of this pattern of light and dark. He's coming famously through the night. He's coming through the darkness to find Jesus, who is the light. But it's so very clear from the conversation that Nicodemus has with Jesus, that he's really in the dark. He's in the dark on so many different levels. He's in the dark because he's not really, one doesn't get the real sense that he knows what he's looking for. I mean, certainly God, or perhaps a deeper experience of God. But he can't even articulate a question. What's wonderful about this dialogue is that Jesus sort of answers Nicodemus, the text said, when Nicodemus hasn't really asked the question. Jesus anticipates what it is that a person that is hungry for God wants to know. What direction that they are guided in. So it's Jesus sort of looking into the soul of Nicodemus and seeing the seeker, someone in the dark who's
looking for the light. But Nicodemus, like many of us, is stuck. I mean, his literalism is kind of comic, right?
Well, I mean, how can an old man be born again? Or how can he crawl back into his mother's womb?
I mean, it's sort of silly. But that's where he is. He's on this surface. This is where literalism is. We look at the word, we have to go deeper. We have to dig deeper in order to understand what Jesus is calling us to do and to be. Nicodemus is in the dark, as we are all in the dark. Have you noticed that we kind of are born into tension? And we grow into it, our children. There's a crisis of our children in terms of mental health, that there's this tension throughout the world, as there always has been. I mean, today is Memorial Day weekend, where we remember people who have paid the price for our tension, for our misbehavior, for our darkness. And so we're seeking somehow a way out of that, a way to be able to deal with the life we live. Yet at the same time, feel the full presence of God. The problem we notice as we have Trinity Sunday here is we're talking, you know, we're not talking about the guy around the corner who's running the corner shop. We're talking about God. There's this wonderful quote from Annie Dillard. If any of you know her as a writer, she talks about there's this wonderful phrase. I've seen it repeated many, many times. He says, "We have no idea what kind of power we are trying to evoke here in church." She writes, "You know, instead of handing out leaflets, the ushers should be handing out life preservers." And instead of having doilies on your head, you should have like helmets, you know, because we are, and it says it here, and we're talking about the God of Isaiah when he gets the call. He says, "I am a man of unclean lips, and I cannot serve you. I'm a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips." The song is astounding, you know. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice. The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor. There is this constant theme of the transcendence and otherness of God throughout this. The description of God in the temple is that the only thing that can fit in the temple is the hem of God's robe. So there's this acknowledgement that God, we're talking about the power, the creator of the universe, the thing that sustains us, not merely creates us, and ultimately redeems us. So that's what puts Nicodemus a bit of a bind, too. How can such a God, how can such a magnificent God touch an ordinary human being, especially one with unclean lips, especially one who has not earned that presence, especially one who has indeed spurned that presence from time to time? How can this possibly happen? Well, there is the rub of the Trinity itself. Because the Trinity, and you write this down, if,
anybody wants to know what the Holy Trinity is, this is my thumbnail sketch. This is God reaching out to us. Simple as that. It is God, the all-powerful, the all-merciful, refusing to stay aloof from his creation, refusing to stand apart from his creation, but breaking through time and space into this world in the expression of Jesus Christ to show us what the face of God looks like. And the work of the Holy Spirit, the work of the Holy Spirit is the work of binding us into that life, of sharing. So it's source, expression, sharing. Now I'm sure if this goes out to Facebook and one of my systematic theology professors were to listen to that, well, he might have a few other things to add. But this is good enough for us. The Holy Spirit is the central part from the human perspective of what God Trinity is. And it works by being in the darkness. We start in the darkness. We start not knowing, because that's what it means to be faithful, to rely beyond reason on the possibility that God will break into my life, to regard this as a great gift of God. I remember when I was training as a chaplain a long time ago, I was at a Roman Catholic hospital, and Sister Gemma, wonderful Benedictine nun, first thing she did with me, she was my supervisor, first thing she did was take away my prayer book. Now, I'm an Episcopalian, you know, and I identify by that prayer book. What's the prayer I need? Now, take that away. And she told me that what you're going to do is you're going to walk into a room of persons you do not know, who may not even have asked for you. And you don't know what their story is. And you don't know what's on their heart. But the Spirit will take care of all of them. Once you open yourself up to the possibility that God can do these kind of things, that God brings relationships together through the power of the Holy Spirit. And so, Nicodemus, as we know later on, does become an apostle or a believer. Prepares the body of Jesus for burial. Because when we think about the answers that we want, that Nicodemus wants, more often than not, we are not going to receive a specific verbal response. You don't Google God and get an instantaneous reaction. More often than not, the answers to the tensions and the darkness around us arise from a heart and a soul that is formed and shaped daily by the work of the Holy Spirit. A soul and a heart that is close to the heart of God, that hears the heartbeat of God with all of its rhythm and daily challenges. That the character of Christians throughout the world is the light of Christ in the world.
forsaken the world. And in the name of God, who is Father and Son. Let us affirm our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. Now pray for the church and for the world.
Inspired by the Spirit, we now offer our Sunday prayers to God in the name of Jesus Christ, saying, Lord, in your mercy, for the fulfillment of the mission of the church. Lord, in your mercy. mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Let us pray in the thanksgiving for those who celebrate birthdays, especially for David Ford, Kim Orley, John Doran. For those who celebrate their wedding anniversaries, especially Mark and Carol Hammond. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
I ask you to pray your own prayers aloud or silently.
We give you thanks, dear Lord, for those who we remember this weekend who gave the ultimate price, the ultimate cost of our darkness. We pray for their families. Those who continue to grieve for them. We also
give thanks for the upcoming marriage of Liam Christopher McNeil and Paige Kathleen Buchholz, which will take place in North Carolina this week. We give thanks for them, for the love that God has given them, the spirit of love that they have been inspired by. Continue to pray, of course, with other conflicts in our world, and for Ukraine, for the Middle East. Pray ambitiously, ambitiously for a lasting peace in those areas.
Pray for the people in Haiti and all the missionaries that serve them.
Hear our prayer.
I invite all those who wish blessings of any kind to come forward at the altar.
Almighty God, we give you thanks for Jan, the presence she has been among us for so many years, and with George. And we pray her Godspeed as she moves to Michigan to take a new house and a new chapter in her life. We thank you so much.
Taking part. Others. Almighty God, with tender love, we call you our Abba. Answer the prayers of your children gathered here, for we rely and have confidence in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Well, please sit back. Let's continue to give thanksgiving for things that are going on here in our parish, how the Spirit is moving in our parish. Katie, why don't you start us off with the latest census that you've got?
The latest census for VBS. So we have 27 kids registered for vacation high school. So if I seem a little tense and panicked, there is good reason. Yes, but it is exciting news. I still could use a volunteer or two. So it's the week of June 17th at 9 in the morning till noon. I could use someone to help out with snacks, with putting the snacks together kind of in the middle of the morning.
if you come up here, man.
Okay,
over the years, when we first started doing blood drive, it has been one of our most faithful blood donors. And because of that, he was always there if he was able or could and was in town. Because of that, he has over those years given 3 gallons of blood.
Thank you, Larry. Yes, Gloria.
Yes, I'm Gloria Blackburn. I just wanted to announce we had a delicious hospitality today. We had volunteers, Bill and Susan, but Susan's, due to the death in her family, she's not able to come, and Margaret picked up for her and has prepared the delicious pulled pork sandwich and some other goodies, so we hope you'll come over and enjoy.
Food is good. Others. next Sunday, I will not be here. I'm going. Like as the scripture says, you don't know where the spirit's going to come from or where it's going. but we will be having morning prayer. Y'all remember that from the old prayer book, so we'll be using that format. I'm going to my high school reunion. I just don't feel like I equal 50 years post-high school. Here it is. So, looking forward to that. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness. By the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in everlasting life.
Amen.
Stand. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For with your co-eternal Son and Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, in trinity of persons and in unity of being. And we celebrate the one and equal glory of you, O Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Therefore we praise you. Joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, and the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. The night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with blessed Mary, blessed Clement, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Gifts of God for the people of God.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting. Body of Christ,
Amen.
of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. On behalf of the congregation, I give you these holy gifts, that those to whom you go may share with us in the communion of Christ's body. Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Go forth in peace, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.